Well, hello everyone, my name is Wiggo and welcome back to another video. This week we're taking another look at Pokemon Blazing Emerald. I've already done a video in the past on this where I picked a new team every single gym, and this week we're going to be playing with only regional Pokemon. What are these regional Pokemon exactly though? Well, in this game you have Pokemon with different typings, like in Alola, for example. Well, normally Skarmory is Flying Steel, right? Well, in this game you have a Skarmory that is Fire Steel. So, a lot cooler. The Pokemon also have different designs. I thought it would be really cool to show them off in action. This game has so many features, and if you want to know more about the game itself, I explain it way better in this video right here. As for the rules for this challenge, I will only be able to use these regional Pokemon in battle. I cannot use any items in battle. Those are the major rules, and let's also try to smash 5,552 likes. Also, let me know in the comments down below what your favorite regional Pokemon in this game was. Before we get into it, don't forget to subscribe as well, because only about 26% of you people are subscribed. And with that out of the way, let's jump right into Pokemon Blazing Emerald with only regional Pokemon. Since we're playing Blazing Emerald, I named myself Blaze. And as you can see here, this game also has custom sprites for every major character, which makes it a lot more immersive than other Pokemon ROM hacks. We then go to the professor where we can pick our starter, and we can actually choose a lot of them. I decided to go with one of the regional forms, so I went with Dreepy, who in this game is a fire dragon type and it looks absolutely adorable. I named my Dreepy Milo because I adopted two cats 2 weeks ago and one of them is named Milo. I'll show you the other one a little bit further up. But first we defeated Mei because she only has an Eevee and Eevee is pretty bad. So after overpowering her, we went to Professor Birch, who gave us a nice new set of balls. There aren't a lot of regional Pokemon available right now, so I'm going to just go through Petalburg Woods and head straight over to Roxanne. And because my Dreepy has now learned Dragon Rage, we can now easily one-shot every single one of Roxanne's Pokemon, but her last Pokemon, the Marini, looks absolutely amazing, and I sadly enough couldn't find it. But don't worry, there will be enough regional Pokemon in this game to show off. And just in front of the cave, we find the best feature ever, a sprite for Mr. Briny, the best character ever created in Pokemon. You can even see him cry, which makes me want to cry. After saving Pico, we get ourselves a free phone and also free nightmares, thanks to this guy's cursed sprite. We then take on Mei again, but she now only has Pikachu and Eevee, so we just Dragon Rage both of them to once again win. But eventually Dragon Rage will definitely not be as overpowered anymore. And when that happens, we're going to have to get some new team members. So after taking the boat with Mr. Briny to Dewford Town, we find out that there is actually an entire new area here with an entire new gym leader actually. His name is Blake and he specializes in dark types, so after fending off Team Magma with him, he invites us to come and take him on at his gym. But before we do that, we have to go to Steven Stone, who is once again on his spot where he is in every single Emerald game or ROM hack. Why can't he be in a tree or in sand or in the water? He's always in the cave. After delivering the letter though, we capture our first Pokemon, the Hoenian Dunsparce, a normal electric type which I definitely won't complain about. And I named him after my other cat, Joey. Just look at these two. They're amazing, I know. Let me know in the comments down below what kind of pets you got. I would love to see some pictures of them, so you can send them to me on Twitter if you would want to. With that pet announcement out of the way, it is finally time for us to take on Blake though. Blake has three Pokemon, a Murkrow, a Sneasel, and a Houndour. Joey is able to deal with the Murkrow with Spark, and Sneasel and Houndour go down to Milo's Dragon Rages. This means that we get ourselves another easy gym badge. When you're playing through Emerald, you know after you get the second gym badge, you're going to have to go and get some knowledge down at the museum together with Archie and the Devon guy. You then save the scientist and move on over to the battle with Mei. She now has Pikachu, Eevee, and Clefairy. Joey is able to deal with Pikachu and Clefairy with body slams and sparks, but ultimately Joey gets taken down by Eevee, so I then bring in Milo and he once again destroys them with Dragon Rage. The Wally battle is also a little bit harder than in regular Emerald, but we still destroy him with only Joey's digs, sparks, and body slams. Then get access to What's His Gym, and to be honest, there should be a sign no kids allowed, because if you touch this electricity, you're probably gonna die. Anyway, the big fat electric man also starts off with his own Dunsparce, and I led off with my Dreepy, who got destroyed by a dig but was also able to hit a single Dragon Rage on it. I then swapped in my own Dunsparce and just kept digging away at his Luxio, Electrode, and Magnezone in order to take all of them down. Actually, the Electrode exploded like it normally does, but we managed to survive and get ourselves another gym badge. As we then headed on over to the fiery path that is leading us to Mount Chimney, I managed to find a Teddy Ursa, which is a fire. And to be honest with you, it looks more like a fire dark type, but I will definitely take a cute little bear that we can add to the team. I also decided to name the little bear Wombo. And he also evolves very quickly into Ursaring. I was then going through the ashy route, collecting all of the ashes that I could, and I found a fire steel type Skarmory, and his name is going to be Zuko, the best firebender in Avatar The Last Airbender. And our journey then led us to a cave where we managed to find Brawly, who is now a miner. Doesn't really make sense to me either, but hey, it's the Pokemon Diamond and Pearl underground mining thing, which I think is very cool that they managed to implement it in this game. We then also get ourselves a ground electric type Tynamo, and we then do the usual business in Meteor Falls. I swear to God, if I have to go to Meteor Falls once again, I will jump in that waterfall. We also capture a Zangoose. I name it Honk because Zangoose can actually evolve in this game. And we also capture its counterpart, Viper, which also has an evolution. And while I was just running through the grass here, I also found a shiny Lombre, which sadly enough we can't use in battle, but he's going to be a nice little HM Pokemon. We then evolve Sviper into Silvipur, which is in my opinion the coolest Pokemon in this ROM hack, and we also evolve Zangoose into Zangoro. Sviper has now an added steel type, and Zangoro has an added dark type. With some very nice additions to the team, we can go up to Mount Chimney and take on Maxi. Since he only has 3 Pokemon, this battle was really easy, even though I went in with only 4 Pokemon alive because the rest died against the grunt. But our Ursaring could take on his Ursaring. He then brought in Camerupt, who manages to take down Ursaring, so I go into my evolved Dreepy here. Luckily, he can take care of Camerupt with Dragon Breath, and Cobby the Sviper can ultimately take down his final Pokemon, Typhlosion, with Poison Tail. Now, normally, we would just be able to go to Flannery now, but there's an added Wally battle at the foot of Mount Chimney. Not that this was any kind of challenge, though, because Skarmory could just Blaze Kick every single one of his Pokemon, and maybe steal Wing the Kirlia, in order to easily overpower Wally. You can now go to the Hot Springs and sit with these nice ladies, and after doing so, we take on Flannery. Flannery leads with a Larvesta, not the hardest Pokemon for us to take down, so we just Blaze Kick and Thieve it with Skarmory. She then has a Camerupt just like Maxi, so I go into Zangoro, but he gets destroyed by Eruption, so I have to go into Milo, who's only able to hit 2 Dragon Breath because we got attracted and paralyzed by Body Slam, so we didn't hit a lot of our moves. Luckily, Joey with Dig can come in clutch and kill Camerupt. Rapidash then finishes me off with Overheat, but that lowers its special attack, so I bring in Ursaring and just start thieving and quick attacking until the Rapidash eventually faints, and it actually also left us with only 2 HP, so it was quite a close call. She then has her own Skarmory as well, so my Ursaring goes down really quickly. I bring in Tynamo to try and hit the Magnitude, but it doesn't work out too well. We get destroyed by Flare Blitz, but luckily our Skarmory, even though it's lower leveled, it is still stronger, and a couple of Blaze Kicks gain us our 4th gym badge. We have to go all the way back to Petalburg, where our dad is waiting for us. He thinks he's about to whoop our ass, but I think it's going to be the other way around. I mean, he is able to start off with Linoone, who manages to kick my ass pretty well by taking out Milo, but I just bring in Cobby, Poison Tail it a couple of times, and take out the Badger? I think Linoone is a Badger? I might be wrong. He then has even more animals, starting with a Sloth, with Earthquake, who one-shots me. So I bring in Vector, the Tynamo, and I hit 1 Bolt Blitz, but yeah, then I also get destroyed. And then bring in Joey, but he is only able to hit a couple of Body Slams, bring him down into red health, but then also goes down to 2 Earthquakes. But one of the Body Slams did paralyze the Slaking, so Zuko can finally finish it off with Blaze Kick. He then has an Exploud, which I Blaze Kick and Iron Head a couple of times, and the last Pokemon will be his Ursaring, which is not the regional form. I hit 1 more Blaze Kick, but ultimately get taken out, so now it's Ursaring versus Ursaring. I Rock Smash him and manage to kill from this range. The last Pokemon, Blissey, also goes down, to some rock smashes. Eventually, I also decided to finally evolve my Tynamo into electric, which looks very cool. And while I was making my way over to the Weather Institute, I captured a Duosion, which looks like a nice pear, like one of those candy pears you used to eat as kids. Joey then also evolves into a beautiful dragon electric type, and with our evolved Pokemon, we can easily take on Shelly, the Team Aqua admin, by thunderbolting her entire team. We still get the cast form, sadly enough, no regional form for cast form, which means we're not going to be using it, but we are going to be moving on to the next Mei battle. Joey manages to kill Raichu with a single dig. She then has a Clefable who takes a lot of body slams and thunderbolts from Joey, but eventually we do come out on top despite it being super effective against us now. She finally evolved her Eevee as well and now has an Espeon with Ice Beam, so yeah, Joey is now dead. Luckily, we still have our little schnick, Cobby, on the team with Poison Tail and Crunch. He can finish off Espeon. Mei then gives us all of her money, which we're pretty happy with. We then meet up with Big Man Scott and go to Mount Pyre to capture some more regional Pokemon. One of them being the most adorable one, a Vampire Emolga, which is now a ghost flying type, who we name Emma. We do the regular shenanigans with Team Aqua once again on the top of Mount Pyre. And I also managed to capture myself the regional form of Ponyard, which looks like a knight in shining armor. And he basically is, because he is a fairy steel type, because, you know, knights slay dragons, fairy is strong against dragon. This little guy definitely got some thought put into him. And I name him Charming because he reminded me of Prince Charming from Shrek. If you've ever wanted to see Winona's mask up and personal, here you go. But her team should be no problem for us to take down, so let's jump right into the battle. Joy took out Pelipper with a single Thunderbolt, Aerodactyl as well. She then brings out Dodrio. I would say that it might be better than Seviper's regional form, but I don't know. It is a flying ground type, so I have to swap in Emolga so that I can Will-O-Wisp it in order to cripple its attack, because otherwise it's going to do major damage on me. I then hit a couple of Spectral Saps, which is basically a Giga Drain form, but then ghost type. I then go down, swap in Ponyard, predict a ground type move, and then go into Honk. With the bird damage that turn, it finally takes out Dodrio. He then has Malarkey, which is the evolution of Farfetch'd, and it's a fighting flying type. Luckily, I kept Joey alive so we can just Thunderbolt it, and the final Pokemon is Tropius. And after hitting a couple of Body Slams, we take out Tropius, and Body Slam seems to be super effective because my Pokemon has the ability where it turns normal type moves into dragon type moves. Since we have already done the Mount Pyre stuff, we can immediately go to the inside of Mount Chimney, where Maxi once again waits for us with Groudon. We actually start off this battle pretty epically with Ursaring versus Ursaring. Mine is 2 levels lower, but still manages to one-shot with a critical hit strength. For Camerupt, I went into Emolga, hit 2 flies, but then got taken out by Ancient Powers. Cobby then takes it out with Crunch, and the last Pokemon, Typhlosion, dies to 2 Poison Tails from Cobby as well. After the battle, my Ponyard also evolves into Bisharp, and I do have to say, he looks pretty stylish. We then lost Groudon somehow. I don't know how you lose Godzilla, but we're just going to have to leave the cave and go look for him. First, we do have to find Mei though, and as it turns out, she's in her usual spot, shopping at the department store. She leads off with a Crawdont, and I am leading with Milo here. I can still kill it with 2 Dragon Pulses despite being at a type disadvantage. She then brings in her Raichu, which I can hit with 1 more Dragon Pulse, but then it goes for a Surf and takes me down. I then go into Emma, U-turn down to Vector, and Vector can kill with Magnitude. She then brings in the big banana tree, so I go into Bisharp, who can take anything that this thing throws at me, so I then kill it with Play Roughs and returns. Espeon goes down to a couple of Play Roughs too, and the final Pokemon Clefable gets taken out by Iron Heads. We now have to go to the Team Aqua base, and here we find one of the coolest sprites for a new Pokemon I've ever seen. Just look at this Delmize. It looks absolutely amazing. Luckily, I did lead with my Fire type, and even though it's a Fire type, it only has Ember at level 48, which I think is not that amazing, but we still kill with 2 of those. We then also Dragon Pulse his Huntail, and the final Pokemon Blastoise also gets hit by 2 Dragon Pulses, but then takes me down. So we throw out Emma again, Spectral Sap it twice, and get ourselves the win so that we can see the submarine go away. Once we did that, we follow it, and we end up in Moss Deep City. And if you switch really quickly between Tate and Liza's sprites, it looks kind of kind of weird. Almost like they're twins. Anyway, we basically have two psychic type killers on the team, Emma and Honk, so this battle should not be too hard for us. They lead with Grumpig and Hypno, so I just take it out with Spectral Sap and Night Slash. Actually, I do nothing else. I just Spectral Sap and Night Slash their entire team. Alakazam dies, Reuniclus dies, Solrock, Lunatone, and eventually Grumpig too. So this was a very easy gym battle for us. Going from one double battle to another though, it's time for us to team up with Steven and take down Team Magma once again. And I'm not going to lie here, his Metagross did basically all of the work. Since I led off with Emma, the Metagross could just go for Earthquake without any repercussions, so we could just one-shot basically all of their teams since they both have a lot of Fire-type Pokemon. After satisfying Nasa by driving them out of the Space Center, we capture another regional form in Tentacool, which is a water-electric type, and our Electric also evolves into Electross, which means that he might finally become useful because Electric has not done anything for the team. We had another evolution, so we now have Dragapult, and with these new buffed up team members, we go and take on Archie. So I decide to set up a Dragon Dance on my Tiena and then just Dragon Darts it with Milo. Next up is Fralligator, who I Dragon Darts to, but we get taken out with an Earthquake because we didn't manage to one-shot. I try to go into Pear, but we get killed by Frostbite, which is probably just like Ice Fang, maybe a little bit stronger, I don't know. Oh yeah, and I also added a Dewgong to the team, which I almost forgot. It's a Water Dark type, so we used him for HMs a little bit. He then proceeds to also kill Emma, but eventually Vector can take him out with Earthquake. Sharpedo then kills Electross, so I bring in Skarmory and take down Sharpedo with Rock Smash, and the final Pokemon is Dewgong, so we can Rock Smash that thing a couple more times, and that way we defeat Archie. Not really easily though, because almost our entire team died. We then go to Wallace in the cave that is literally useless in this game. I don't know why we don't get to use this cave like ever, but he sends us on a scavenger hunt in order to find a big green snake who once again shouts at his children so that we can finally enter the final gym without having to die because there are legendary Pokemon fighting in front of it. Juan was waiting on us all this time though. He didn't even leave his gym to try and save the region, so we're going to have to show him his place. We actually don't start off the battle really great because we get frozen on our first turn and Milo gets taken out by some Frostbites. Zuko then comes in and manages to kill the Glalie with a couple of Iron Heads before he brings in Mamoswine. I can hit another Iron Head, but he manages to take me out with Earthquake again. So I then go into Emma, and Emma can actually take down Mamoswine, Walrein, and Froslass with Spectral Saps before he brings in his regional form Steelix, a ice rock type, which kills me with Ice Beam. He then proceeds to also kill my Duosion, so I have to bring in Vector, who can kill with Earthquake, and the final Pokemon is Weavile. Just one more Earthquake though, and we managed to finish off Juan and gain our final gym badge, which means that we can now go to the Pokemon Victory Road and battle Wally for one last time before we take on the Elite Four and champion. Leads with his Altaria, so I am leading with Milo, but I know that I can't touch this because it's part fairy type in this game, so I go into Tentacruel, hit a poison jab, and get taken out by Earthquake. Emma then finishes off Altaria with Spectral Sap, and he then brings in Delcatty, so I'm going to stay in Will-O-Wisp it and then kill it with Fly. I am also able to hit one more Spectral Sap on the next Pokemon Magnezone, but then I get taken out by Zap Cannon. And Milo can take out the last three Pokemon with Devil Darts, which is a fire type move in this game, not dragon type. Actually, the last four Pokemon, Magnezone, Roserade, Gardevoir, and Gallade, all died to my Devil Darts. Oh, and this might seem weird, but the first Elite Four member in this game is not Sydney, it's Phoebe. So let's take on Phoebe first. Nothing besides that changes though, she still has a ghost type team. And she does have an Emolga of her own, so I'm going to be leading off with my Bisharp and try to take it down with some Play Roughs. I eventually do, but she used Destiny Bond, so yeah, I'm dead too. Luckily, I also decided to bring Honk with me, who can then one-shot Banette, Dusknoir, Gengar, Hoenn, Lantern, which is a ghost fire type, and then finally Koffer Grigas with two Night Slashes, and that's Phoebe defeated already. The next trainer we face is Serena, someone with a new face as well. She has grass-type Pokemon. Luckily, we have our fire-type Milo on the team, as she leads off with a Sunflora, so I'm going to kill that with Devil Darts. Then also kill Hoenian Shuckle, which is a grass-rock-type with Devil Darts, Vileplume with Devil Darts, Hoenian Reuniclus, which is a grass-psychic-type, which we can also one-shot with Devil Darts, Ferrothorn goes down the same way, and the final Pokemon, Meganium, doesn't, because we finally die to the toxic damage. But we still have Emma on the team, so we just fly it twice and take out Serena so that we can move on to Elite Four member 3. You might know him, Bead from Pokemon Sword and Shield is in this game. A very cool reference in my opinion, so let's see what he has in store for us. He could have Psychic or Fairy types, but as it turns out, they chose Fairy types for him, so I'll be leading with Bisharp and Iron Head, his first Pokemon Wigglytuff, to take it down. For Azumarill, I switched in Jello to kill with Poison Jab. He brought in Sylveon, but we Poison Jabbed that thing twice too. He has his own Bisharp, so I know I have to bring in Victor and just Earthquake that thing 3 times to take it down. He then has the thickest boy of all time, Goolossal, so I'm going to go into my Steel type again. Bisharp is going to take it out with a couple of Iron Heads. But we do also almost die to some Hydro Pumps. After this close call, Togekiss can finish off Bisharp, so I bring in Tentacruel, overcharge it, and win against Bead. One more Elite Four member in our way before we take on the champion, and that Elite Four member is Drake. He has a Dragonite on the team, so I'm going to be leading with Honk and go for the Fake Out to do some chip damage. I then manage to get a critical hit with Crush Claw, which kills from this range. For Flygon, I swap in a Mulgat, predicting the Ground-type move, and I then go into Jello because he can take more hits, but sadly enough goes down to a Stone Surge and an Earthquake. So I go into Dragapult, who can Dragon Pulse the Flygon in order to one-shot. Garchomp manages to survive a Dragon Pulse and hits back with an Earthquake, which hits me very hard and takes me down. But Emma is still here to save the day. One more Spectral Sap and a Garchomp is also finished. He then has a Dragapult of his own, so I'm going to be staying in here, hit 2 Brave Birds, and ultimately go down to this Dragapult so that Honk can finish it off with one last Fake Out, because otherwise we probably won't have been able to outspeed it. He then goes into his second to last Pokemon, Salamence, who takes me down, so I have to swap in my boy Bisharp and take down Salamence with Play Rough. And the final Pokemon that he has is Drasparath, who very luckily for us misses a Thunder so that we can hit back with a Play Rough and take down Drake. That was the last Elite Four member battle that we had to do, so let's move on over to Wallace and show him who's the real champion. He leads off with a level 71 Wish Cash. These levels have been way, way too high for me at the moment, which means that I have a level cap, so I can't go above level 60, except if I use a Rare Candy. My level 60 Honk, though, can still take it out with Fake Out and Crush Claw. He then swaps in Tentacruel, so I try to go into Vector and hit it with an Earthquake, which doesn't really work out because we get killed the turn after with Liquidation. So I bring in my own Tentacruel and try to kill it with Overcharge, which doesn't quite kill, and he manages to take me out in the end. So Emma has to come and clean this up with one last Spectral Sap. And after this, Lapras comes in. I am able to hit one more Brave Bird, but sadly enough, after that, I get taken out. But the Sandstorm damage also takes down Lapras. I then go into Honk as he goes into Crawdaunt, and I'm able to hit 2 Crush Claws because he wastes his first turn by going for Sword Stance. He then goes into Ludicolo as his next Pokemon. And with just 2 more Crush Claws, we can crush the bird, or should I say Dancing Duck, and his last Pokemon will be Milotic. So I swapped in Bisharp, hoped to do a lot of damage with Play Rough. I did about half of it before getting taken out by 2 Resurging Waves. Luckily enough, this also confuses the Milotic, so we can bring in Milo, Dragon Pulse it a couple more times, it hits itself in its confusion, and Milotic is down, which means that we have now become the champion of Pokemon Blazing Emerald with only regional Pokemon. I do have to say that with hard mode, this game is definitely not easy because it gives you a little bit of a disadvantage by putting the opponent's Pokemon at higher levels than yours. But besides that, the game is really not that amazingly hard. Do let me know in the comments down below if you enjoyed Pokemon Blazing Emerald, if you're going to be playing it yourself, and what game should I play next, because I know that there's hundreds of thousands of ROM hacks out there. With that out of the way, I also want to thank my membership and Patreon supporters. If you want to support the channel yourself as well, you can do that by clicking the link in the description. It is always appreciated, but not needed. And with that out of the way, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. I'm Zwiggle, and I'll see you guys next time.